Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and yesterday Apple released watchOS 9 Beta 2. This is available to developers and was released alongside iOS 16 Beta 2, iPadOS 16 Beta 2, tvOS 16 Beta 2, HomePodOS 16 Beta 2, and macOS Ventura Beta 2. All of those are available to developers now. And as you can see, this was 427 megabytes on my Series 7 Apple Watch. It can vary a little bit, and there are some new changes and updates in this particular update. Now first, let's take a look at the build number so we can see what version we're actually on. You can do that by going into Settings, under Settings, go to General, then About, and you can see the actual version here. It's 20R5307H, and that tells you exactly what version we're currently on. Now, as far as new features in this update, well, Apple talked about some but never added them in previous updates. And the first one you'll see is called Medications. Medications is something they added in iOS 16 Beta 1, but they never added into the watch. So you'll see it says the first time you go into it, use the Health app on iPhone to set up medication logging. And within the app, you can set up a medication. So let me add one. We'll add a simple one. You could pick whatever you want, but I'll just pick one here. You can choose the type. Then you can also choose the medication strength and of course ask your doctor if you're taking any medications, and we'll just add a time of day. Then we choose the shape of the pill. There's a bunch of different other options here as well if you need to choose that, and then you can choose the color as well. So hit next, you can add details and hit done. And now I just added ibuprofen. So if we go to the watch, we should have that on our medications app. So if we go into medications, you'll see here it showed up in medications. So very simple, and it will give you reminders as to when you need to take them. You cannot do a whole lot with this here. You can just see log is taken, or you could skip it and then hit done. So not a whole lot you can do here. You have to do it mostly from the iPhone app, but it will be nice when watchOS is out to everyone with the new features. Now, Workouts has an update as well. So if we go into Workouts, scroll all the way down here, under Workouts, if you're in Running, Apple talked about a bunch of new features. So we'll go down here and go to Outdoor Run. And we'll start the Outdoor Run. And when you're running, now we have a lot of those features they talked about, such as running power, ground contact time, vertical oscillation, running speed, and stride strength. And if we scroll down using the digital crown, you can see the different zones for running. Keep scrolling, and there's more options. So you'll see a split pace, you've got elevation gained, and again, your move information. And then of course your music to the right, and then to the left, you can end the workout. So all of this information is here and being gathered this time around, and with all of that additional information added if you're a runner. So it's great to see them add that. It wasn't all there in Beta 1. If you're using the Sleep app to monitor your sleep, maybe you're wearing your watch to bed, it actually tracks more information. Apple talked about that in the keynote, and after you've used it for sleeping, you can then go over to the Health app again and see more information about your overall sleep. So if we go down to sleep in our watch app or on our health app on our iPhone, you'll see that we have additional information here, show more sleep. And some of this was in Beta 1, but you'll see it's starting to show the amounts for measurements, sleep goal, time in bed, and time of sleep. And then there's stages, awake, REM sleep, core and deep, percentages, and more. So you'll have all of this information if you're using it regularly. They continue to update this. Not all of it was working properly in Beta 1. With watchOS 9 and iOS 16, you can now mirror your watch to your iPhone to help you control it a little bit better in accessibility settings. So if we go into Settings, then Accessibility, then Apple Watch mirroring, this was not working at all in Beta 1. It would show up, you could control it, but you couldn't actually see the screen mirrored to the iPhone. So you'll see we can scroll here, we can maybe switch watch faces, and it's controlled on the watch and iPhone at the same time, and it mirrors it pretty well. So if you want to scroll through, maybe we'll select astronomy here, use the digital crown, we can use it, and it works on both devices at once as you're seeing. So it's mirroring what we're doing. We can press the different buttons and so on. So this is something that's actually working with Beta 2 where it wasn't with Beta 1. Also something that seems to be working much better is Siri and dictation. So if we activate Siri, you'll see here that Siri is now working and it should be listening to what I'm saying and then typing it out properly. It may take a moment, but it didn't seem to be working very well at all with Beta 1. Now it seems to be working properly and hopefully it continues to work well and gets better over time. Now within the feedback app on iOS, if you have beta 2 or any of the betas, just go into the feedback app and you can see the different notes for the current releases. Under that release, the first thing you'll see is it says under general, after updating to watchOS 9, your Apple Watch Series 4 or Series 5 will recalibrate and then estimate its maximum battery capacity more accurately. So if you have a Series 4 or 5, you'll actually have that recalibration. Apple did that a while ago with the iPhones, with the iPhone 11 series. So now they're doing it with Watch 4 and 5. So if we go into our settings, go down to battery here, under battery, it may give you a recalibration message under battery health. And you'll see I'm currently at 100%. Now, in previous versions of watchOS, this wasn't necessarily at 100% all the time. So it looks like maybe it's recalibrating and giving us a more accurate reading. And as far as overall battery life on this is not as good as watchOS 8 versions, but it does seem to be okay. Currently, you'll see if I go home, if I scroll up, you'll see my battery life is at 93%. Now it's only been off the charger for about an hour. And of course it's on screen here and it's turned on completely all the time. So you're going to have a different experience, but either way, it does get me through the day, but definitely drains faster than it did on watchOS 8. That's typical of early betas. So I wouldn't really put that against it, but just keep that in mind if you're wanting to try this out. Now, as far as the notes are concerned, according to the notes, there are resolved and known issues. There's one resolved issue for a widget kit modifier, and there's 21 known issues. So just keep in mind that there's still a bunch of bugs in this. It is an early beta. And for example, the power saving mode setting isn't respected during workout. So if you're working out and using power savings, it will still track GPS and your heart rate. So it's going to still use those sensors and not save you any power. Also, automatic split pace calculation is incorrect. And then those ground contact time, the new things such as stride length and vertical oscillation aren't enabled in Fitness Plus specifically. So those aren't enabled yet in Fitness Plus, but if you're using Fitness Plus to work out, those won't be there yet. They'll be there probably in a future beta. And that leads me to, should you install watchOS 9 beta 2? And typically, if you have an Apple Watch lying around, you don't mind if something happens to it and that it's not perfect, then I would try it out. Otherwise, I highly recommend against installing this until the public beta is out, as there's no way to go back to a previous version without sending it into Apple currently. So if the watch gets bricked, it doesn't work, or maybe you're just having a bunch of bugs, you want to go back, there is no way for you to do that at home so far. So hopefully they update this in the future. It did look like we were going to get some additional options for that, but right now there's no way to do that. And also I would expect watchOS 8 pretty soon. That will go along with iOS 15.6, and we can expect maybe a beta 4 or release candidate as soon as today, or maybe even next week. But I would expect it to release to the public within a couple weeks, where we'll have watchOS 8.7, and then of course watchOS 9 beta 3 probably within a couple weeks. Usually Apple with early betas is on a 2-week schedule, so maybe a couple weeks from now we'll see that. Other than that, that's all that's in watchOS 9 beta 2. Of course, if you find anything else, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below, but it looks to be one of the more stable versions and performance is quite good as well. You've seen maybe a small hiccup. There's some frame rate drops here and there, but for an early beta, it's actually doing much better than iOS, in my opinion. Let me know your experience and what watch you're using in the comments below. And of course, if you're curious about what watch face I'm using, this is actually the Infograph modular watch face. Let's try that again. Infograph modular with the app Lumi in the middle. So you'll see here, if I go over again, the complications, this is Lumi. It's a paid for app. It's actually one I bought. So that's what it's here in the middle, but everything else you can just set using Infograph modular. If you have any other things to add though, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. And of course, if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper on the iPhone, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. If you haven't subscribed already though, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.